I'm Paulshinn. Welcome back to my channel. I have had so many comments and questions, emails about how I converted the daily driver Model A to LED headlights and how bright they are and all that. I just totally glossed over it in the Christmas parade video because I didn't think it was really worthy of explanation. Well, come to find out, I guess it is. So today it's a really short video. I'm just going to show about the LEDs, how they work, and how to refocus your Model A headlights. Before we get started, I just want to give a huge thank you to Thomas Looney. Thank you so much for your generous donation. It's generous people like you that help keep this channel going. I appreciate it very much. There's a donation link down in the description below if you'd like to help keep this channel going. Appreciate that very much. Thank you. The bulbs that I bought are made by Logo Lights. Here's their website. I'll go ahead and put a link in the description below as well. But all the Model A part suppliers, Burt's, Bratt and Snyder's, all of them have these listed in their catalogs. You can get these pretty much anywhere, but just beware, sometimes they're not in stock. Model A headlights are easier to disassemble by hand than a fly with a fly swatter. Just pull this clip down here, it's spring-loaded. Pull that, rotate forward, as you can see how this works. See, real simple. And then carefully pull this out. Make sure the lens doesn't fall out on the ground or that little gasket behind it. And then pull it upward. And then there's the headlight, the reflector, and it looks like my gasket is still intact. There's the little clip up top right here. It clips onto the top of the headlight bucket. Just put this aside carefully. And here you'll see there's that fancy LED bulb right there. Half of the secret to brighter Model A headlights is, in fact, the LED bulbs. But the other part of that is the reflectors. From the factory, the Model A came with polished silver reflectors in the buckets. And those are about the most reflective thing we've found yet to make Model A headlights with. Now, a lot of the reproduction headlight reflectors now that you find in all the Model A parts catalogs are chrome-plated whatever. And chrome is an okay reflector. It's nowhere near as good a reflector as the polished silver. However, I think it was last year, Bratton's started having some made like these. These are some of those that have a flash-plated aluminum, which is within a few percent just as reflective as the polished silver. They're amazing. I think all the Model A part suppliers are selling them now, but Bratton's is the one who had them made. So as soon as they came out with them, I bought probably the third or fourth set they sold, put them on this car. They are amazingly reflective. They're awesome. Every bit as reflective as the silver ones, in my opinion. So get you some of these. You need those. You want these, but you need those. Here on my workbench using the variable power supply, I've got it set to 6.5 volts, and I'm going to show you how the different contacts here give you high and low beam, which isn't really high and low beam. All you get with LEDs is bright and brighter. You see there's two rows of LEDs on both sides. You get just one row when you're on low beam, and you get both rows when you're on high beam, like the finger quotes there. Well, let's see if this burns the camera up or not. Did you get to see that? That's low beam. That's high beam. It's probably not even going to show up. Even with sunglasses on, I'm still seeing spots. These things are crazy bright. But the neat thing is these will work on 6-volt or 12-volt systems. Since all of my A's run the 6-volt positive ground system just like original, these are no conversion at all necessary. Just plug and play, and I'm going to show you how to do that. So you see I've got the original type sockets here. I've modified mine a little bit so that they won't accidentally short out, but they're essentially the stock Model A headlight sockets. Now, these LED bulbs, since they have essentially the same contacts as the incandescent bulb, but they're not indexed, you can put them in upside down accidentally. If that happens, all you'll get is when you put it on low beams, you'll have high, and when you put it on high, you'll have low, but you'll be able to tell that. If that's the case, just turn the bulb over and put it back in. Now, I've marked mine with a little T for top, so I know which way to plug it in, and that's it. Once the LED bulbs are installed, before we even think about focusing these, the first thing we need to do is make sure that the headlights are actually pointed properly. So here's how to do it. Get a 3/4 inch wrench and loosen up the nuts that hold the headlights on. With the headlights just a little loose, get a straight edge and put it across the front of both headlights. They should be exactly straight all the way across. Make little tweaks as necessary to get them exactly straight. Next, put a straight edge against the light vertically and get it to where it's just about 1/4 of a bubble down from perfectly horizontal. Do the same for the other one. then tighten them back down. Now we're ready to adjust the focus on the bulbs. Park the Model A about 10 or 20 feet away from a wall or some other flat surface. Remove each of the lenses again. I always like adjusting my headlight focus without the lenses on. These Fresnel lenses distort the light. It's a whole lot easier to do it without the lens on. If you know how to focus a mag light, then you can focus a Model A headlight. On the back of the headlight bucket, you see this little screw right here. That's what you use to adjust the focus of the Model A headlights. Now, while pushing the reflector back against the bucket as hard as you can, sometimes a helper helps for this, adjust the screw on the back of the headlight bucket until you get the smallest image possible on the wall. Well, that's as small as it's going to get right there. That's it. It's adjusted. Put the lens back on and you're all set. Thank you so much for watching this video. Now you know how to make your Model A a lot more drivable and a lot safer, especially at night, and a Paulshinn approved modification to the stock Model A, and also probably the simplest. Thank you again so much for watching. Appreciate it. If I don't get to see you before Christmas, Merry Christmas to you and your family, and I'll see you on the next video. Man, wait, can I do those? Wait, no.